Greenland is at the very top of the world. It's a unique place. Percent of the country is covered by an ice cap, 4 kilometers thick in places. Greenland is the largest island in the world and one of the most sparsely populated places anywhere. Life might be a struggle, but that doesn't dim the enthusiasm for football. More than 10% of the 57,000 people that live here regularly play the game. John Torsen is president of the Football Association, which was founded back in 1971.
We can't just take the bus to the next town or city. We have to sail or fly, and it's very expensive. This is one of our biggest challenges. We have local committees for each football club that work very hard raising money for their teams when they need to travel.
The first football championship was held in 1958, and today the federation boasts 70 affiliated clubs with 5,000 members, a third of them under 18. National coach Tekla Gebrelui couldn't have a more different background from his charges. He arrived in Greenland 11 years ago from Eritrea, and his job is very much a labor of love.
It's very difficult because we don't have the resources and it's very expensive. As a volunteer coach in Greenland, you have to pay for everything. You pay for your own transport, the phone bills, the internet. You have to take care of everything. And so family members can get very annoyed when I spend so many evenings coaching. And the only thing I come home with are expenses. Nothing else.
Geographically speaking, Greenland is part of the North American continent, but history links it to Europe. However, Greenland is neither a member of CONCACAF nor UEFA, let alone FIFA. One of the main problems is that it's impossible to maintain a grass pitch because of permafrost. With the exception of the FIFA-funded artificial surface of Kakatok, in the far south of the island, matches are usually played on gravel pitches. The season, short under the best of conditions, is heavily dependent on the weather. So football can usually be played outdoors only from the end of May until the middle of September.
If we could have an indoor pitch, we could play football all year round, or maybe another artificial surface. That would be a huge help. I also think that the coaches need more tools so we can improve our training and maintain the motivation of the young people. The will is there, the motivation is there, the desire is there.
Given the enthusiasm, it's a real shame that this combination of factors hinders the development of the game in Greenland. Just organizing the national championship takes huge effort on a vast island with no road connections between settlements. Currently, there's a system of local events leading to a final tournament played over a week or so at a single location. This year, in the capital, Nuuk.
We have a few competitive games in the capital, Nuuk, because there are 4 or 5 clubs who play against each other. But along the coast, where there are only 1 or 2 teams, it's difficult. When all the towns are involved, the distances are overwhelming. So the idea of a national league is, I have to admit, far off in the future.
As well as finding time to train, players taking part in tournaments also have to commit up to 3 weeks of their time, as travel to and from the finals can take a week in itself.
It's difficult, but they really love it and they really want to take part. It's sometimes a challenge for them to find the time to come and train and get time off work to play in tournaments. If their employer says no, then we have to select the second best player. But they want it so much that some of them voluntarily quit their jobs. It's something we experienced 3 times last year. They just quit their jobs in order to be able to play football. We were at a training camp in Denmark and we had to travel to Bermuda for a tournament. So when they returned, they had no job to go to, although thankfully they soon found a new one. They're really dedicated and they really want this.
Greenland won home rule in 1979, and along with the Faroe Islands, now forms part of the Danish Commonwealth. Their only regular source of overseas competitive fixtures is the football tournament at the biannual Island Games.
It would mean a lot to us to be a part of the international football family. We played international futsal games last winter when we invited the Nordic countries across. But only one of them took part, the Faroe Islands. They came here and we played against them and we were just as good as they were. That sort of thing motivates us.
It would be so cool for Greenland, with so few inhabitants and so much land, to make it onto the international stage and play games against Spain, France, Germany, you name it. It would be amazing. I dream about it, and I believe it will happen someday. But maybe it won't happen in my lifetime.
There's nowhere on the planet immune to the charm of the beautiful game. But here in Greenland, much work has to be done. Football infrastructure, pitch improvements, all are required. But such is the enthusiasm, there's no reason to suppose that in the long run, all the manifold obstacles to the sport's development can't be overcome.